All right, good morning. We are going to jump into the next area of videos, which is I'm going to do several videos on scientific notation and how we get from scientific to decimal, decimal to scientific, and even how we use that in calculations and using it with our calculator. So let's go ahead and jump right in. Before we talk about how to convert from one form to the other, I want to start by making sure that you understand exactly what scientific notation is and why we use it in chemistry. So the first thing is, why do we use scientific notation in chemistry? The reality is that in chemistry, we deal with a lot of very large numbers, and we deal with a lot of very, very small numbers. For example, one number that you are going to become extraordinarily familiar with is the number one mole. And 1 mole is equal to 6.02 times 10 to the 23rd. Okay? Now, if I write that out longhand, it looks like this. That's 1 mole. And it's a counting number, just like a dozen is 12. It's that kind of a number. It doesn't have units associated with it. But that's a number you're going to use all the time. Now, I don't know about you, but I have no interest in typing that into my calculator. Therefore, we use scientific notation. It's much easier to use. Because atoms and molecules are so, so, so tiny, we also deal with very, very small numbers in chemistry. For example, the mass of one carbon atom is 1.994 times 10 to the negative 23rd. Okay, now, I don't know about you, but again, I don't want to write that out longhand. It's much simpler to use it in that form. So, that's why we use scientific notation. And here's a really important piece of information. You will need to be able to make calculations in scientific notation. It's a really big deal. You're going to use these numbers all the time. So not only do you need to be able to get from one to the other, right, from scientific to decimal, decimal to scientific, but you also need to be comfortable making calculations using those numbers in scientific notation because they are so big and so small, okay? So that's something we have to be able to do. Now, the next thing I want to talk about is, what is scientific notation exactly? What are the parts and pieces of something in scientific notation? So there's two pieces to scientific notation, basically. You have a coefficient. That is the number that is before the times sign, this and this, okay? Scientific notation has two pieces to it. You have some number times 10 to some power. So in the numbers I've already written, 6.02 would be the coefficient of that one. 1.994 is the coefficient of this one. Now, we can also have coefficients that are whole numbers. We can have 2 times 10 cubed, okay? This is the coefficient. We could have 3.47 times 10 to the first, okay? That's also the coefficient. We can, but the coefficient has to be a number that is between 1 and 9.9999, all right? Now, what that means is that this has to be less than 10. All right, so the number 20 times 10 to the first is not a correct representation of scientific notation. What we could write is 2.0 times 10 squared. All right, or 2 times 10 squared. And whether you have zeros after that or not has to do with significant figures, which we'll get into in yet another video. But just understand that the coefficient, the number before this times sign, has to be a number that is less than 10. It can be a whole number, it can be a decimal. Either one of those is fine. The second part has to do with the 10, okay? And scientific notation always refers to something that has a number times 10 to some power. And we can have positive powers, so this would be 3 times 10 to the fourth, or 5.7 times 10 to the ninth, or 2.0 times just 10, as I mentioned above. These are all, and this is 10, if there's no number, we assume it to be a 1, right? So these are all positive powers of 10. We can also have negative powers of 10. We can have 3 times, I'll get rid of that 0, we could have 3 times 10 to the negative 4th, or 5.7 times 10 to the negative 9th, or 2.0 times 10 to the negative 1. Okay? They mean very different numbers, and we're going to get to that in our next video. What does it mean to have a positive power of 10? What does it mean to have a negative power of 10? So we're going to talk about that